We are in the middle of a remarkable global property boom, and COVID has played a big role. Here, in three charts, we ask whether this boom has changed into a bubble about to burst in numerous global cities. Throughout the coronavirus pandemic, house prices have risen at an unusually fast pace. By the end of the third quarter of 2021, the average annual percent change of nominal house prices across the OECD countries hit an astounding 15%. The only time we have seen anything like this was the rebound after the financial crisis in 2008. Let's look more closely at the 46 countries that are covered by OECD data. Since the pandemic began in early 2020 and bringing us to the end of September 2021, the OECD average of real house prices was 13%. Some countries have seen prices simply skyrocket. Russia, New Zealand, Turkey, and Czech Republic are all over 20%. Growth in property prices in global cities are traditionally driven by investors. They hope the value of their homes will increase long term. Since homes are so expensive to buy upfront, a common way to make this investment affordable is for home buyers to take out a mortgage and then rent the property out. The renters, in effect, pay their mortgage. It's called buy to let. Here is a calculation of the number of years a flat needed to be rented out to pay for the flat in several global cities in 2011. The pandemic, however, has dramatically changed the preferences of urban renters. Imagine you are one of the millions of renters in a global city paying exorbitant rent. Shops, restaurants, and entertainment venues are closed for months, and offices were abandoned. And now, you are likely able to continue to work remotely. So why not leave the city for greener pastures? And that's exactly what people have been doing. Now, if you're a property investor, reliant on rents, this is a big problem. What's worse, property values have soared so high in these cities that years have been added to investors' wait for their rewards. Take London as an example. In 2011, it would have taken 23 years for a new owner to pay for her flat if she rented it out. Now it would take an additional 10 years. In Toronto, the same story. Now here's what's puzzling. All of this should be deterring new home buyers in the cities, but instead, prices are soaring even higher. Why? What's going on? Well, historically, low interest rates are continuing to attract mortgage seekers, and pandemic restrictions allowed many people to accumulate savings for deposits. On top of that are people's stubborn expectations. Urban home buyers still appear to have very high hopes for long-term value gains. But as this chart shows, their hopes might not mesh with reality, at least such as it is now. Back to our main point. The changes the pandemic has ushered in very well might burst the housing bubbles in major global cities. UBS compiles an annual global real estate bubble index, and in 2021, there are several cities that are raising red flags. The property markets of 12 world cities are overvalued, and alarmingly, 9 of the world's most important cities are firmly in bubble risk territory. Amsterdam, Paris, Stockholm, Vancouver, Zurich, Munich, Hong Kong, Toronto, and Frankfurt. Whether these bubbles burst remains to be seen, but there's a high likelihood they will. In three charts, we've examined what impact the coronavirus pandemic has had on global housing markets. First, we saw simply that global house prices have skyrocketed throughout the pandemic. Next, we learned that although house prices are also soaring in global cities, the demand may be weakening. And finally, several major urban property markets have not seemed to adjust to this new reality yet, creating real estate bubbles. The question is, will they burst? Thanks for watching. Our sources are in the description below, and please like and subscribe. Let us know which topics you would like to see in future episodes.